بسم الله، الحمد لله، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. We are going to read an authentic hadith that was narrated by Imam Bukhari. And we're going to read it in Arabic by the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then translate the meaning to English, and then talk about what we learn from it and what we benefit from it. عن عائشة رضي الله عنها قالت قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من أحدث في أمرنا هذا ما ليس منه فهو رد من أحدث في أمرنا هذا ما ليس منه فهو رد رواه البخاري narrated by Imam Bukhari. عائشة رضي الله عنها, the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم wife, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with her, narrated that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam have said, whomever come up with an invention or an innovation or a new thought or a new idea in Islam, in the matter of Islam, in the soul of Islam, in the religion of Islam, as a new rule, a new ibadah, a new action, a new, you know, thought, a new saying, ما ليس منه, and that innovation or new things is not based on religion, they have no evidence supporting it, then it is actually mardood. It's basically get thrown in their face. It's not taken. It's rejected. طيب. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in this hadith is telling us a real important information. And the hadith is talking back when the Sahaba radhiyallahu alaihim were taking the information from the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and that things did not happen yet. It started happening after the death of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when people sway away from the right path after the Khulafa al-Rashidin and after the, you know, basically the Sahaba, after the Tabi'in, people start swaying away and coming up with new thoughts and new ideas, new action, new sayings. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is telling us that any person or a group or a sect that can come up with new information or a new ibadah, a new act of worship, or a new dua, or a new thought, or a new idea, or a hadith, a made up one, hadith mawdu', basically what we call also in Islam bid'ah, innovation in religion. ما ليس منه, if all these information that were brought to religion by individuals or group or sects, if they have no base on the Quran or on the authentic Sunnah or on the action and the sayings of the Sahabi radwanullah alayhim, the companion of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with them, then it is rejected. It is rejected and refused, and it will not be followed at all. And if somebody follow it, then they're actually swaying away from the right path and they're sinning. And the person who invent this innovation in religion, the person who come up with those new thoughts, is actually a sinner. And he will be given the sin of every person who follows their innovation or new invention. Because Islam is a religion to follow. We're supposed to be following Islam, not coming up with new things, claiming to be part of Islam. We're supposed to be followers, not inventors, not creators. We are the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Islam is the religion chosen by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for us human to follow. Then we're supposed to follow and not come up with new school of thoughts or ideas. We're not supposed to do that. Islam have always fought the bid'ah and innovation. It does not take it, and it takes it very seriously. It does not accept it. And it basically warns people from coming up with it or following it. That's why when we're studying Islam and learning about Islam and trying to be proper Muslim, we seek the Quran, we seek the evidence from the Quran, the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the noble Quran, from the authentic Sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, hadith al-sahih wal hadith al-hasan, and the way and the action and the sayings of the companions of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, manhaj al-salaf al-salih. That's what we do. We seek our religion from those sources. We don't come up with new sources or new information or new prayer or whatever. طيب. What also we learn from this hadith is that if you come up with something new in religion, you're not actually getting a good deed for it. You're getting a bad deed. So obviously, learn your religion and stop thinking too much and stop trying to make up some things because you think you're smart or because you think you're amazing or because you got, you know, high education. If you get a PhD in anything, that does not mean that you are an expert. It does not mean that at all. What it means is that you were actually good at test taking, research, and you, you know, you took the time and effort to go register, you paid the fees and dues, and you know, you passed the test, you studied, you read, you know, but it's only the information that the school or the university or the college have ordered you to study. It's not all knowledge, especially when it comes to Islam. Islam is endless knowledge. You can never attain all the Islamic knowledge by getting a bachelor degree in Islamic science or a master or a PhD. It means nothing. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not have no education. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught him the religion and he taught it to us and he was illiterate. He couldn't write. So Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was able to deliver the message perfectly without the education that nowadays we go crazy for. I'm not against education. Education is proper. Getting those degrees is fine. There is nothing wrong with that. But don't think just because you attain those degrees that now you are a scholar or you are a person who can, you know, come up with new thoughts in Islam. No. We're supposed to be following the sources of Islam, not coming up with new ideas or new deeds. Islam, as we mentioned, was built onto submission, full submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and complete following and obedience, not innovation and addition. Islam is complete. It does not need any new addition to it. We don't need to add any new information at all. It's a complete religion ready for us to study and seek and follow. So by listening to this hadith and understanding what it means and understanding the lesson that we learn from it, dear brothers and sisters in Islam, avoid bid'ah, avoid innovation as much as you can. Anytime you hear new information, seek the evidence behind it. Find out if it's legit or not. Find out if it's authentic or not. If somebody tell you, I read this dua somewhere here, memorize it and say it. Find out if this dua is authentic before you actually memorize it. Find out if it's true. If somebody email you, and this is really common nowadays, people are trying to do that way. They have good intention, but the problem is they're sending false information. When you're exchanging emails of da'wah for us public, make sure that the hadith you're spreading is actually an authentic hadith. Research it. Don't go exchanging hadith that are mawdu' or da'if, because there is a lot of them going on nowadays. Anytime you get an email that tells you the Prophet ﷺ have said this, or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have ordered us to do this du'a, and you've never heard this du'a, or you've never found it before, research it prior to memorizing it or spreading it between people. Because if you don't, and you spread it, and it's wrong, you're also getting some of the sins, just like the person who spread it originally. Because we are supposed to authenticate our information by linking it to the proper sources. I mentioned the sources. The book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Quran al-Kareem, the Sunnah al-Nabawiyyah al-Sharifah, Hadith al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam al-Sahih, the authentic Sunnah, the authentic sayings of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and Manhaj al-Salaf al-Salih, and the way and the action and the sayings of the apostle, of the companions of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with them. You have to authenticate the information prior to spreading it and exchanging it with others. Otherwise, you would be committing a bad deed by doing so. So please be aware before you exchange those emails. Research it and then do it. If it's wrong, delete it. Warn people from it. If it's right, go for it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless your deed of, you know, sending it and, you know, spreading it. Because the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us to.